I look into your eyes, I know it's real. That's how I know it's all a part of y'all's will. Raising my offspring with tender love and care. Around the house, sometimes I stop and stare. Prepare my meals with them spices and herbs.
My heart's burning passion for you dissolves my desire for any other woman I previously lust. I may have wanted to hold our telepathy and your connection to me, respectively, renders you the perfect mate that resonates straight from my soul.
Yeah, shalom, shalom. Once again, you understand the sounds of the voice of your good brother, Taza Doc, right? About to give you some right knowledge right here, because let's face it, fellas, a lot of guys has a problem. They have a serious problem getting women, whether they're Israelite, whether they're in the world. A lot of these guys, I mean, they trick dough on women, and I'm going to show you, you really don't have to do that. So if you want to attract women, this is the G code, right? I'm going to give you the G code for that, right? For men that want to learn the game, which is actually the G code. Now, let me ask you a question. Are you a nice guy? Do you think women will be attracted to a decent man with a good personality? Check this out, kid. I used to think that when I was about 13, right? And I consistently struck out with women. Strike one, strike two, strike three, you're out, right? But don't get me wrong. There's nothing wrong with being a nice guy and treating a woman well. You understand? These are great qualities, but they won't help you get and keep a woman. I'm going to give you the game, man. G code. You know what I mean? Now, as I learned over the years, you dig what I'm saying, Dillette? As I learned over the years, women don't choose guys based on how nice the guy treats them, right? Women don't choose guys based on how nice the guy treat them. You know what I mean? They choose guys who make them feel certain powerful emotions. Now, guys, you should be paying me for this, because I'm giving you the G codes. I'm giving you the real game. You dig? I'm giving you the real game, right? Now, specifically, women choose guys that they're overwhelmingly attracted to, right? They're overwhelmingly attracted to the guys that they really choose, right? And so for a woman, the key thing, fellas, is that she looks for in a man is his body language. My dude, you sitting slouched over, you know what I mean? How you carry yourself, are you confident? Are you looking down when you're talking to a woman? Are you looking away? She reads all of that body language. Women are masters at reading your body language, you feel me? So the simple truth is that the woman's brain is much more responsive to the signals that a man's body language sent off. You dig? That says more to her than anything else that's coming out of your mouth. You understand? So if you want to give the right body signals to make her attracted to you, King, check me out by her. Check me out by her. Play this about 4 or 5 times. Matter of fact, subscribe to my channel, A Spokesman for Men, because there's really nobody out there speaking for men, and a lot of men just don't have that G code. They don't have that game. I'm not promoting nor adultery, none of that. I'm just giving you the game, man, so you don't have to be a simp for the rest of your life, because that's a bad thing right there, right? So dig what I'm saying, right? If you want to give off the right body signals, listen up. I'm going to introduce some effective methods that I've came across that attracted women throughout the years. Whether you're one of them worldly dudes that, you know what I mean, just trying to pump and dump, or you trying to, you know what I mean, you're trying to get a loyal wife. Now, I came across a lot of crap, right, that people would say. They trying to always give you advice and all of that about meeting and sleeping with women and all of that. Like I said, man, I came up around hustlers and pimps and all of that, right? So what I'm about to give you, fellas, is not gimmicks. This works for real. I'm not telling you to go out and use this on loyal women, but it works whether she like it or not, man. She can know it, man, but it's just something about this mechanism that make it work, right? So you want a wife? You want a girlfriend? You want to attract multiple women? G. Cole, I got you right here, right? You want to keep a woman interested in you, even if you're in a long-term relationship? This is a G. Cole right here, right? If you want a certain girl to be your woman, to be your wife, to be your girlfriend, I got you. Now, I'm going to hit you, son. It's tempting to want to show off all of your best qualities and hope that a woman would suddenly realize, wow, he would make a great boyfriend or a great husband, right? But that's not how it works. That's not how it works. And you rush into her arms. It doesn't work like that. As you probably already know, that almost never works. Women don't choose a guy who makes the most sense either. They don't choose guys based on that, right? They choose guys who make them feel certain powerful emotions. Specifically, they choose guys that are overwhelmingly attracted, that they are overwhelmingly attracted to. And so this raises the question, right? How do you tap into the primal urges and make her attracted to you? You know that chick that you've been wanting, this female that you've been wanting, and she haven't been giving you an attention? Yo, you're using the wrong game, man. You're sending off bad body language. You're coming off unattractive, right? Why body language, King, is the key to turning her on, right? It's real simple, right? The simple truth is that for hundreds of thousands of years, men had seduced women without saying a single word. Now, before language was actually even spoken, the only tool that men had to turn a woman on and convince her to be with him was what? Was his body language. So if you're interested and learning how to do this, I know some of you need this, because you can't figure out how you keep going out. You can't get a date. You can't court nothing, whether you are Israelite, whatever. You in the world, you just ain't got no game. You got bread. It doesn't take that, man. See, you're still much better off focusing on, yeah, I mean, even if some of you men just want to pump and dump, if you still a worldly dude like that, you're still much better off focusing on getting her turned on and attracted to you first, and then trying to appeal to her logic. They don't appeal to a rational mind and logic like that, right? Dig what I'm saying? So guys who get the right girl that they want, they've learned this lesson. Peep game, King. They've learned that the most powerful way to give her these obsessive, addictive emotions is through their body language. You feel me? See, if you can get a girl to think about kissing you, get her craving your touch, you feel me? How you carry yourself like a man, right? It demands her attention. You feel me? When you say a girl's hot, the average dude, when he says a woman is hot, now he's talking about, when he says a woman is hot, he's probably talking about the shape of her face, her body, her stunning eyes, her smooth, soft skin like silk, right? Her full lips. See, the crave of her hips, when he see her walking, he's talking about all of that. He's talking about the bust of her chest, the swell of her chest and all of that. You feel me? See, these shapes and curves and contours combine to make the man feel turned on and join in towards her. You dig what I'm saying? But when a woman says a guy is hot, some of them may not even, a lot of women won't agree with this, but I'm telling you the game, man. I know some of these women better than they know themselves, right? So, but when a woman says a guy is hot, she's not talking about the shape of his body. She's not talking about his face, right? More often than not, she's talking about how he carries himself, right? How he carries himself, right? I'm gonna check something out, right? Check this out, right? I was looking at a study, right, that they evaluated women, right, on what made them attracted to men, right? And check this out, right? Peep game, right? And they had women looking through pictures of men, and they was rating the attraction of men from 1 to 10. You dig? But the research did something very crafty, very sneaky. So among the hundreds of pictures, the women that was actually just flipping through, they flipped through multiple pictures of the same men, right? What? And so some men were standing, some men were sitting in different positions, you feel me? And slightly different facial expressions, you know what I mean? Going through all of that. And so amazingly, women would rate the same man differently depending on how he held himself. You dig what I'm saying? So that was all based on body language. You feel me? So one way of standing would get the man a 5 or 6. And another way, just simply adjusting his move, would get him a 9 or a 10. And she didn't even realize it was the same man. Goes back to prove my point. Why? That's because women are highly turned on to the signals of a man's body language, the signals that a man gives off. They get an overall impression of a guy's attractiveness and think of him either as hot or not based on the signals that he's given off. Do you dig what I'm saying, Kings? And how they treat you. You feel me? If you're giving off the wrong signals, she's not going to treat you like she's interested in you. It's the G code, King. And when you know how to give off those signals, yo, man, you're never going to have problems with a woman again, man. I should charge you for this, man. This is a G code, man. I used to use back in the day, man. You feel me? So how do you, what was the power of attraction, fellas? I know you want to know, man. How do you stand out in the crowd, right? And attract women? I'm not about that life anymore. You feel me? But a lot of men, you still have problems. I mean, you just simping, man. You just simping. You still have problems getting women, man. You tell me, like, nerdy. I mean, you want to throw over all your money, throwing racks. You going to strip clubs. Dude that goes to a strip club, you got a problem, man. You ain't got no game. You got to go to a strip club, man. You watching porn. You got a big damn jaw of Vaseline. A brother was on my call that I was doing early, man. We was going over marriage. He talking about he got a problem with porn. I mean, no disrespect for the brother. So it inspired me to do this video, man. I'm trying to give him the G code so he don't have to sit there with a big damn jaw of Vaseline and baby oil breaking the Most High's laws, right? So I'm going to give him the G code. Game. This is the game, right? So the power of attraction, man, right? How to stand out from the crowd and attract the woman that you want in your life, the women that you want in your life, regardless of your looks. Check it out, man. Feel what I'm saying. Biggie Small was, what he's saying is, I'm back, big black, ugly as other, but I stay Gucci down to the socks. He's still attracted chicks. So that proves, man, it's not about your looks. It's not about your size. I'm trying to give you the game, man, but if you don't listen, it's going to go over your head, right? So regardless of your looks, don't matter whether or not you have a lot of money, if you know the G code or whatever. Whatever else you think, I'm telling you, man, that's not what's necessary, right? And you're free to share this video by all means. As a matter of fact, share it. A lot of guys need this, man. A lot of guys need this, right? Just don't alter my words, man. Don't try and steal my game. So first tip that I'm going to give you, right? Women don't rate men the same way that men rate women. Get that in your head, King. She'd be like, damn, Tazza, dog, you messing up my whole game, man. Yo, man, I got to do it, man. Simps need this, man. Simps need this. You know what I mean? A lot of men been raised by women, man. The only thing they know is what a woman taught them. Real man got the ball now, man. So women don't rate men the same way that men rate women. So for men, attraction is physical, at least in the beginning, right? Men are drawn entirely in by the way that a woman looks. Women's criteria for men are completely different. You feel me? Women can appreciate and are attracted to attractive men. The criteria is not nearly as highly a priority as it is for men. You don't have to be the most handsome guy. You could look like you could lift damn concrete. You know what I mean? That doesn't really get it all the time either. That's all good, right? That's all good news. If you look like a film star and all of that, which most of you strive for. So what are the qualities, though, that women are looking for? They're not really looking for all of that. It's good. It's an addition if you have that. You know what they look for? They look at the more detail later, but the main criteria is your strength, right? Not necessarily physical strength, but that real manlyhood that you see in me. You know what I mean? Stand up kind of dude, man. Speak his mind. That strength. You know what I mean? You got to have a little bit of humor also. You got to have humor. And you got to be fun to be around. You know what I mean? You got to have character, right? Charisma. Personality. Got to have style. Got to have some swag, man. And again, not necessarily physically strong. You could look like you would damn eat concrete. That won't get it, man. So, and the other thing, fellas, being unpredictable, right? That's attraction. That's how you attract a woman. You want to be great with a woman? Be unpredictable. Next thing I got to tell you to do, man, G-Code, develop your self-confidence. You got to be confident. Women don't want to be around no damn whip. That mean? You know I was going ahead. You know I was going ahead with this. Everyone tells you that women are attracted to confident men, right? That's an actual fact. Big facts, right? Women seek out confident men because it is an alpha trait. You feel me? It is displayed by the men who are leaders, right? Who are leaders of the pack. Don't you will go out and trying to be a leader and you've been a simp all your life, right? It's, you know why she's attracted to a man like that? That's a reliable indicator that a man is a good provider. You feel me? See, women are biologically, whether they like it or not, and they might be disagreeing with me right now, but I know you better than you know yourself, Eve. Women are biologically programmed to seek out confidence. You dig? Confidence is a side of strength. Physical strength? Sometimes. But more often and more importantly, it's an indicator of mental strength. Strengthen your mind, King. Get your mind right. I tell you that all the time, right? Why is mental strength important? Because you can't navigate yourself through this modern world and its challenges without that mental strength. You can't have just physical strength alone. You know what I mean? You're gonna run into a serious repercussion with that. You need to be able to negotiate life's obstacles, and that requires mental strength. You feel me? You gotta have some intelligence, right? That requires mental strength. See, women see men who have this ability as providers of emotional stability. He knows how to deal with her. He knows how to deal with her head and so on and so forth. These men make great companions to have by their sides through difficult times. She's trying to talk to you. You can't even hold a damn coherent sentence, but you look like you could lift concrete. She ain't really feeling you, son. You don't know the G code. Let me tell you something, man. If you're not confident, right? And no one tells you how to become confident, right? If this is something that you gotta have, man. And if you are not confident, let me tell you what you could do, right? Answer is very simple, right? In the words of the famous American psychologist, William James, if you want a quality, act as if you already have it. I'm going to say that again. It might have went over your head. If you want a quality, act as if you already have it, right? So if you want to be confident, stick out your chest and start acting confident. It's a law of attraction, kid. Act as if you're already confident. Act like you're already confident person from this day on. You talking to a damn woman, you looking over shoulders, you looking down, nah, son. It's not going to get it for you. You dig? It's not going to get it for you. How would a confident person behave? You got good posture. You ain't sitting like this. Imagine this. You think woman's going to be attracted to you like this, King? You sitting like this. You on a damn date. You sitting like this. Out of here, man. Come on, man. Come on, man. Even if you a dude, man, you want to be able to chick. She... Come on, man. Fuck out of here, man. So you got to have good posture, right? Yeah, you know I mean? You got to have good posture, man. From head to toe, man. You got to maintain good eye contact. If you can't look a woman in the eyes, you're coming off as weak, man. That's simp. You know what I mean? You got to speak clearly. Smile sometimes. It's all right to smile. You got to move around with energy. Move with ease, enthusiasm. Positive attitude. Be optimistic. Stop being so damn pessimistic. And you got to be compelling to others. Damn, he relate to a lot of people. You know what I mean? I ain't bragging, but I'm a born leader. I was never meant to be a follower. I lead. You know what I mean? I always end up being the leader, man. Women are attracted to that characteristic, to that trait. And you got to have assertiveness, right? Not being coerced by others. I go into a store. If I don't want to buy something, damn it, I'm not buying it. And that ticks me off. You know when them salespeople come up to you in the store? Oh, yeah, yeah, but I tell them quick, listen, man, you're not going to coerce me into buying anything that I don't want, so don't harass me. You know what I mean? If you want to help me, you could get my damn bags when I'm ready to leave, and you take them to the damn car for me. And they usually leave me alone. I really talk to people like that, man, because I hate someone pushing up on me and trying to do pressure sells. I don't like that. Third thing you need to build with a woman, you want to be good with women, King? You got to build a connection. A connection is having the feeling that you and the other person have the same outlook in life. You got to have some kind of connection, man. Where you going? What's your vision? You got to have vision that you and them may want the same things and you're feeling some of the same things, right? Where is the connection? See, people often describe as clicking with someone. That's a connection. Yeah, me and her click. We have chemistry. That's a connection right there, King. The interaction, when you got a connection, is effortless and it's very rewarding. So how do you build a connection with a woman? How do you build a connection with a woman? Attitude is important. Assume that there will be a connection. Assume the two of you will get it on together. When you talk to her, act as if you both know each other for a long time. Damn, I'm giving you too much game, man. I probably should stop right here, man. I probably should start. I should be getting paid for this, man. Real talk, man. It's the G code, man. I ain't supposed to share this with no simps, man. Nevertheless, man, you act as if you will get along together. And when you talk to her, act as if you've known her for a long time. She's going to feel at peace, man. Because if you're uneasy, I'm going to tell you something, King. You damn nervous ass simps. When you talk to a woman, you all damn nervous. That turns her off, man. How the hell? You're going to protect her. You damn nervous. You're all damn nervous of her. She got more damn masculine energy than you. Ah, son. I ain't going to get it for you, man. You dig? So when you talk to her, act like you've been knowing her for a long time. Ain't no need to be nervous. The only thing's gonna come out of that nervousness is, yo, man, you're gonna push it off to someone else. But don't be overly familiar. And you gotta use the first name, man. You know what I mean? Use the name when you talk to her. Be very present with her, in other words. And so this means maintaining eye contact, not being all damn nervous. Listening to what she says, and then asking open-end questions, right? Be fully engaged with the conversation. Then you got to inject some emotions into it. Don't be afraid, right? You got to touch on feelings and emotions, but don't be too indirectly and don't overdo it. You understand? G Code, man. How do you feel about that? What made you want to do that? Ask questions, man. You already know what it is. He that is asking is ask the king. Have you ever felt? You know what I mean? Ask some open-end questions, man. Stop saying stupid stuff. You just ask the closed-end question, and she's quiet. And you don't know what to say, so you start to get nervous, and boom, you talk yourself out of it. She don't even want to see you again. You know what I mean? See, women fill the world around them much more than men do. You got to make a profound statement. Let me give you a universal truth, right? This makes her think, wow, this guy, he feels the way that I feel. See, when you ask these questions and you could build that connection, she'd be like, wow, this guy feels like I feel. This guy hasn't really figured out G-code, man. And you got to use a little bit of humor. Make a woman laugh, that builds a great connection. But don't go overboard. You know what I mean? Don't turn into a damn Kevin Hart. You know what I mean? Chris Tucker. Might be good for a while. You're not a damn clown, man. You ain't no damn Pennywise. Don't OD with it, you dig? Gotta have a light touch, man, when it comes to human, man. Because you're gonna, this crazy weak dude right here. You know what I mean? Don't overdo it, man. I'm gonna tell you something, kid. It's about how you make her feel. Not so much about how you look. Not so much about how much money you got. Why you see some bad chicks, man, with this ugly dude, man? You dig? And this dude ain't got nothing. You be like, damn, why she with him? That's how you make her feel, man. G-Code, I'm giving you the game, man. Real talk. You can like that, understand it, believe it or not. Now, sure, women are attracted to good-looking men. But what is more important to them, and far most important to them, is how a man makes them feel, right? So this often explains why you got this Halle Berry type woman with this ugly ass dude, man. You know what I mean? With this ugly dude, you know what I mean? You know what it is? That man knows how to make her feel good about herself. You feel me? That's all that is. That's all that is. Remember, you hear her buddy say, damn, why you with this ugly ass nigga? And she be like, hey, girl, he treats me nice. I like how he make me feel. You know what I mean? Not just emotionally. You know what I mean? He laying it right. You know what I mean? So you got to remember this piece of advice, Kings. You got to remember, act as if you had a certain quality. And that quality became yours. Act as if you were someone who women feel great around. Law of attraction. Act it out. It's going to be that way. What would you say if you made women feel great? That's what you got to say to her. How would you carry yourself? That's what you got to do. How would you behave around a woman? How would you approach a woman? You still be all nervous? Ain't gonna get it, man. That's not gonna give it, man. Personality. Gotta have some swag, man. You dig? You gotta have some swag, right? Personality trumps over all. Now we know, I know you heard this many times, right? Probably from women who've actually reject you with a patronizing, you got a great personality. But I'm not looking for a relationship right now. Blah, 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 blah. But she hears you out. We're not fobbing you off. Your personality really is the ace up your sleeve. But the problem is, most men make a good personality with being a damn nice guy. Simpson. Which is a huge turnoff to women. You ever hear a woman? Stop me where I'm lying at, fellas. How many of you fellas in the room hear a woman and say some stupid stuff, man? Because women, I don't know, man. And maybe they don't think sometimes. You ever hear a woman, yeah, I like him, but he's too nice. The hell is that? Isn't that what you want? Isn't that what you want? Well, you heard the saying many times that, hey, man, he's too nice. That's a huge turnoff for women. Being a nice guy is not the same as having a great personality and vice versa. So when we talk about personality, we mean specific traits that women find attractive in men. Personality is your secret weapon because it is actually the origin of all the characteristics and behaviors that make a woman feel a certain way about you. Remember what I said earlier. Women are not nearly as attracted by how a man looks as to how he makes her feel. And how a man makes a woman feel all originates from what? It originates from personality. So what personality traits attracts women? Confidence. That's the hallmark of a strong man. A potential protector. A provider. A mate. Confidence. Ability to make her laugh. Women associate funny men with good times, right? If you can make her laugh, she enjoys being with you. Intelligence, being knowledgeable about topics that interest her. You know what I mean? Creativity. Creativity shows deeper aspect to your personality. That's a mysterious attraction. Being skilled at something. Skill shows competence. Self-reliant. Again, a strong trait of a man, right? A sense of style. You feel me? Women love a man who stands out for all the right reasons. Look at GQ magazines. For ideas, if you don't know how to, you know what I mean? You ain't got no swag. You don't know how to dress. Being considerate. No, this just doesn't mean having good manners. But it also means being considerate towards the feelings. Do small things. You know what I mean? Let the woman know you was thinking about it. Be attentive. Notice and pay attention to the efforts that she make. You know what I mean? If she's trying to look good for her, you got to let her know, man. And also, as confusing as it may seem, you got to be complex. You got to be challenging. Women love a man who they cannot figure out. Let me tell you something, King. If you don't hear anything else from this call, dig what I'm saying right ahead. Women are more attracted to men whose feelings are unclear. Take that with you. Take that gem with you, G-Code. If you don't take anything else. Women are more attracted to men whose feelings are unclear. Men that they can't figure out. You know what I mean? Avoid too much consistency. Act differently towards what she expects now and again. Want to be great? Be unpredictable. Mix things up. Be ambitious. Not just an ambitious in a career, but an ambition to reach your goals in life, to achieve something or be someone. Be upbeat. Be happy. Be exciting. Show passion. You know what I mean? I'm not telling you to be no damn romantic because I'm not from Rome. I'm not romantic. But women love a man who's passionate. And we don't just mean in the romantic sense or the sexual manner. Dig what I'm saying, King? Passion is related to love. Love is the highest elevation of understanding with a force so strong that it can't be broken. Peace to the gods, by the way. So if you could actually demonstrate passion, a woman equates that to love. You're capable of love and care, which in turn influences her on a subconscious level to feel you can look after her. You gotta have charm, man. Charm is nothing more than warmth. Being able to make the other person feel special and appreciated. You got charm? The other thing I'm gonna tell you, man, is model yourself after a suave man, right? I'm surprised when men don't do that. You're a simp But you don't want to model yourself as a suave man, right? Model yourself on men that women love, whether real or fictional. Simply put, that's the G code, right? What would James Bond do? What would James Bond say? What would Hugh Hefner say? Sounds silly, right? But if you follow their mannerisms and attitudes of men, women like, you won't be too far off the mark. Dig what I'm saying, man? G code. So the next time you hear a woman swoon about a man, which is not cool if they're in the truth, right? And she's attracted to that man, you could learn a lot just by listening to her answers. Not enough men ask their female companion about what makes her attracted to a man. Spending the evening asking questions, and you'll be surprised of some of the answers. See, what a guy thinks a woman likes and what a woman actually is attracted to is very, very different. You dig? And you got to be positively different. You don't want to be like everyone else, man. Be different, right? Be different. Don't be like everyone else. If you're surrounded by guys who are all the same, they know how to fix cars, they watch the game, they lift weights. Be the guy who knows about style, who could talk about history, who could talk about art. You dig? Be the different guy. Be authentic. You feel what I'm saying? Because the world is filled with people who are mere imitations of other people. I'm different, man. I'm dissident. Who've actually compromised who they are in order to be accepted. And to hell with that. That's not me, man. There are very few true individuals anymore. Everybody's a damn cookie cutter. They're emulating someone else. See, most people suppress who they are, what they believe, and what they stand for in order to live lives that other people's approve of. That's not me. I'm a real dude, man. I'm a real dude. See, everyone wants to fit in, not me. I am, and I will be, me. Don't be the one that folds and become like everyone else. Be who you truly are. Be yourself. You know what I mean? Authentic individual. Authentic people are immensely attracted. There's something special and magnetic about them, right? They seem to exist outside of the ordinary. That's what people like, man. They make life more interesting, inspiring, inspiring others to be truer to themselves. It's times a dot a day, all day. Other thing I'm going to tell you, fellas, you got to make contact, man. Stop being weak, make contact. Many people avoid eye contact because they're shy. Man, you could forget about having a strong connection with a woman. You avoid an eye contact because you're shy. That's a drawback right there. So the person's on the receiving end of your non-eye contact will interpret you as either disinterested or arrogant. You dig? There is no doubt that the last thing that you want to express in the message that you are sending is avoiding eye contact. Let me give you a little bit of game right here, right? Let me give you a tip, right? If you're having trouble making eye contact, look at the point just above the bridge of the nose. You know what I mean? Of the other person. And it looks like you're maintaining eye contact. Because eye contact is very important. It develops intimacy. Eyes at the wall are the windows to the soul. If you want to build a connection with a woman, then eye contact is both vital and effective. Now, if you're a married woman, you know damn well you shouldn't be looking at no other man's eyes. You got to discover your passion. What is your passion in life? Find out your passion. What are you here on earth to do? You got to learn to do that. You feel me? And you men, you got to learn to flirt, man. You got to be your own man. Flirting essentially is a playful verbal exchange between two people that hints at a deeper interest, right? Usually sexual. So then the surface communication suggests flirting is usually playful and lighthearted, but with occasional well-timed seriousness, right? You know why people flirt? People flirt because they wanted to go to a higher level. You feel me? Men got to learn how to do that. Body language, verbal, slower speech, lower tones, lower volumes, teasing, questions, right? And you got to attract. Don't just chase. You men got to learn to attract. The whole point of everything that I'm giving you, man, is to teach you how to attract a woman. But the vast majority of men listening to me right now are still in that mindset that they would actually be chasing a woman's attention and approval. There's a difference between chasing a woman and attracting a woman. See, you attract a woman by working on the attractive characteristics that I'm going over, man, that I've been outlining to you. So get rid of the mindset that you are actually chasing women. So the correct way to think of it is that you are learning new skills that are attracted to women, and you will then put yourself in the situation where you will actually encounter more women that you are attracted to. You dig? So it is, man. And look like you're self-made, man. Don't look like you some damn carbon copy. Look like you've made an effort. You feel me? And one of the key things that I could tell you, man, don't get put in the friend zone. What? Don't get put in the friend zone. From the start, you must express an interest to be more than just a friend. If you're in the damn friend zone, dead that. You done screwed it up already. So to avoid that deaded friend zone, once you get in a friend zone, it's rarely an escape from that, right? You need to establish early on that you want to be something more than friends. That sounds obvious, right? But you'll be surprised, King, at how many men try to worm their way into a woman's direction and affection and hope that she will just see the light and will want something more down the line. That's guaranteed friendville. That's guaranteed friendville. You need to avoid that path. And the best way to do that is to make your entrance known early on. And you do that primarily by flirtatious, touch, whatever, man. You understand? I'm not telling you to be mischievous and crude. You know what I mean? But you got to let her know, man. And don't be needy, man. Don't be needy. She's not going to be interested in no damn needy man. Even if she likes you in the beginning, man, that's going to end it. You can't be needy. Don't be a damn puppy either, man. And what I mean by that, you're a puppy if you think your role in life is to make her happy. You're a simp. That's a simp. You think your role in life is to make her happy. You're a damn simp. You're running whenever she calls. You're going to get things for her. You sit around waiting for her attention. You think she's the best damn thing in the world. You're looking longingly at her whenever she talks. Simp shit. You feel her pain and try to comfort her. You follow her every damn way. She's going to get tired of you, man. You're a damn simp. That doesn't get it, man. That doesn't cut it. When I was in the world, man, I was at the club one night, man. And you know what I mean? This guy was in a nightclub spending all damn night stroking his girl's hair, real talk, man, all night. Like some damn handmaiden, right? On call. It was damn pathetic, man. And I lost respect for the girl, too, for letting him do that. I lost respect for both of them. Understand? One of the biggest mistakes that you can make, man, is doing something like that. They act as emotional tampons for women. That's a damn simp. He's a damn emotional tampon for a woman, listening to their problems, sympathizing, making sounds, that's awful. Get your simp ass out of here, man. Sounds like a simp dog, right? Is lending up an understanding ear. Wrong, 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 wrong. By doing this, by doing these things, you emasculate your damn self. You emasculate yourself. That sort of thing women do with other women. You putting your damn self in the damn friend zone, you damn simp. If you start doing the same thing, she's not going to see you as a strong male figure. She'll see you as a female friend. Go and get some damn pink panties, you damn simp. That's not to say don't care about her problems, but it does mean you won't indulge in an emotional discretion of the topic. The correct, let me give you some game, man. G-Code, right? The correct response is to say, you're one of the smartest women I know. Doretha, you'll figure it out. You always do. You know what I mean? So say, how about we go to the bar and forget about this BS? Now she may like this. She might like that response, but she may not like it, but at least she will respect you for it. And no doubt, she will be on the phone to her female friends at the end of the night to talk to them about her problems. You dig? That's not what you're there for, okay? Don't make that mistake. Don't make your world revolve around her. You're the one who chooses, not the one waiting to be chosen or get approval. You're the damn man. You dig? And work on your voice, man. Women love a man with a sexy voice, right? It's the quality worth developing, right? Don't seek her approval. Check what I'm saying about this, Josh. Don't seek a woman's approval, right? Again, it is extremely chasing, right? If you're seeking a woman's approval, you're chasing her. That's not attraction. Whenever you try to get a woman to approve of you, in whatever way, I don't give a damn, you are sending her the message that you consider yourself inferior to her. You better dig what I'm saying, King. She will lose respect for you, man. She will lose respect for you, and you could kiss her goodbye. You could kiss any chance of attraction goodbye. Make no apology for who you are, man. Yeah, I don't like that coat you got on, Tyler Dog. Okay, in that case, I'm going to wear it every time I meet you. That's what an alpha says. You're sent behind. Oh, yeah, well, do you like this one? You go into a damn store with her. You see something you like. And she say, oh, yeah, I like this one better. Yo, that's a test, King. Why the hell so damn what she like it better? And you pick up something. She said, I don't like that one too much. In that case, I might get two of them. You dig? Real man stuff. That's alpha stuff. A simp, you're going to switch up and do what she wants. Do what she likes. I don't give a damn if you like that better. This is for me, not for you. You know what I mean? You feel me? Seems cold and harsh, but you've been a real man, man. Stand up kind of dude, man. Stop trying to impress her, man. You don't make an apology for who you are. You like that, but I like this, and this is for me. You don't be no her major douchebag. You know what I mean? If you be her damn douchebag, then you're going to have a lot of problems, right? You have a lot of problems. Do you understand? Don't change your ways, man, to win a damn woman's approval. It doesn't work that way. The moment you even show any willingness to compromise who you are, You get a damn pat on your head. You've lost. Your woman respects a man that stands up. You're going to lose it. And so I'm going to tell you the other thing, man. Game. Bring her into your world. This is the complete opposite of trying to win her approval or chasing her. That's simp crap. Make your life an exciting as possible, right? You should do this regardless if you're trying to attract a woman. Then show her a glimpse of your world. And if she asks you if you're available, don't say yes, man. Say I'm off to a pickup. An amazing bottle of whatever. If you drink, I'm going to get an amazing bottle of wine. And she asks, what are you doing tonight? Don't just grunt. Nothing. Even if that's what you're doing, you damn sick. Which you should say, hey, yeah, I'm going there. You know, I mean, I'm going to check out this whatever tonight. I hear it's good. You create an exciting world, man. Then you invite her to join. Whenever a woman reaches out to you, it's usually she wants to hook up. You need to get that in your mind, man. And don't listen, man. Simp 101. Don't flash cash, man. Don't. Come on, King. Don't do that, man. One of the biggest mistakes that guys make when they're trying to attract a woman is spending money too damn easy. That's a quick down turnover for me, right? That's a quick turnover for me, right? They start flashing money. You know what I mean? Spending money on her. You know what I mean? You shouldn't be spending money on her in the first place. They buy coffee. They buy all the drinks at the bar. They buy lunch. They buy dinner. They pay for the movie tickets. What's the message that this dude is sending? What is he sending the women? The only way I could be with you is if I buy your company, you dumb simp. That's what you're sending her. That sounds like the oldest profession, doesn't it? See, women want to be with... Is a woman really going to want to be with such a guy? Do you want to be with that kind of woman? See, guys who spend readily... Or in reality, saying, all I could do is buy your affection. I'm a simp. All I could do is buy your affection. That's all I have to offer. Women are not impressed by that. She'll take your money and still go and get her black blown out by a different dude, by Alpha. At most, she will see you as a damn meal ticket and will laugh with her friends. You know what I mean? At what a damn simp you are. Dig what I'm saying? I'm giving you the game, man. I'm giving you the game, man. You can like that, understand it, believe it or not, right? When you meet a woman, you know the best way to meet her? You just smile. Just nod, say hi, that's it. Whenever you see a woman that you're attracted to, just give a quick shalom, hi. That's it. That's all this is to it. You don't need these damn pickup lines. Oh, that's BS, man. Well, that's BS. You don't need none of that garbage, man. You got to be a great conversation and stuff. Got to know how to do that. Spit that game, that G code. You know what I mean? And there's a natural progression you need to observe. Right? For social and historical psychological reasons, women will resist anything that makes them look easy. You feel me? I know it's a double standard, but promiscuous men are seen as conquering heroes, right? While promiscuous women are seen as a hoe. I know it's unfair. And so for this reason, women will go to any lengths to protect their image and the relationship. So one way to protect their reputation is to play hard to get. Most of you guys don't know that. She wants you just as well. But the problem with most guys, you attempt to attract women. Every guy is trying to hit a home run. instead of just running the first base. They want to go in for sex on the first encounter. And one swoop. If it happens, it should happen without expectation. So what happens more often is that you meet, you chat, you isolate her from her friends. You know what I mean? Both of you end up in a quiet place and so on and so forth. You leave early. This is on your first encounter. You make excuses and you leave if it's going too well. You call her the next day. You invite her out. You know what I mean? See, the goal is to show her a part of your world and to invite her in to join you. Not you to take her to a damn comedy club and you both check it out in a new restaurant. You invite her, you know what I mean, into your world. You go back to your place. There's food, there's drink, there's music. You close in for a kiss, game, G-code, right? And the rest is straightforward from there. You really trying to get with a woman, man. You don't want to take out to no damn public place and, you know what I mean? You want to end back up at your place, G-code. Be a good listener, man. Most men think that they're adequate listeners, but they're not. So the fact is, most men don't really have a clue when it comes to listening. Men only fear, or should I say hear, the facts. And they leap to answers where women want a man to hear the process. They want him to feel it, the drama. You know what I mean? So for women, the journey is more important than the destination. So if you want to be a good listener, you will have to be willing to join her on the journey, exploring, right? Every fork in the road, every alternative route. You understand? Women love to talk. You gonna listen? See, men make the mistake of only listening to what is said. You understand? That's wrong. When it comes to women, you have to pay attention more to what is not said. You have to be adept at reading between the lines. G-code. See, when a woman asks you, do you want a coffee? She really means, I want a coffee. You dig? Please get me one. That's what she really means. In fact, whenever she says, do you want to? It's safe to bet she wants that. What? It's not a suggestion. It's an indirect request. See, women are far less direct than men are. Most men don't know this, man. Giving you the G code, right? So the true power of listening comes into its own when you have deeper and more engaging conversations, right? So if you could demonstrate that you're a good listener, then you could actually infer and interpret meanings from what she's really saying. And you have a powerful weapon indeed. You dig? So you could demonstrate that you are a good listener, right? You could listen for the clues she throws out, right? I just moved here from wherever. I'm just finding my place in New York. Wow, so glamorous. What were you doing here? Let me guess, modeling, gardening, equipment. Thank God it's Friday. I've had a nightmare week. Be a good listener, man. Figure it out. Become the best. Become your best self, right? Be the best you. Develop yourself. Have goals. Have dreams. Be decisive, right? What do you want to eat tonight? She asks. I'm not fast. What do you want? You reply, right? It's up to you, she says. No, really, I'm not bothered. I'm happy with what that's not a leader. That's not a good leader. You see what I'm saying? You've just become a major damn simp by that response, right? That's another test that women do, man. I'm giving you the game, man. G code. Remember this. G code, right? So when she asks you to make a choice, then you make a choice. Women often will ask you to order for her in the restaurant. Right? Don't be indecisive, going back and forth. Now you get it. See, that's a sign of insecurity, King. Now you may think you're being considerate towards her feelings, but you're really being weak. That's simps. That's what simps do. Where do you want to eat tonight? She asks. Well, let's go to this new vegan restaurant in town. It looks great. That's how Alpha answers it. That's much better. If she doesn't want to go there, you suggest she'll let you know indirectly. Let's go to this new vegan restaurant. It looks great. Well, wouldn't you like to try the Japanese restaurant? She might say. Yeah, I've noticed that place for a while. We'll do the vegan restaurant next week. I'll try. Let's go. That's how it should work. Doesn't work like that with most simps. Most simps don't do that. They're always trying to cater to the damn woman, man. And you got to be a rock. What I mean, you got to be a center. You never allow a woman to take you off of your center. A woman wants a man who can take care of business. Be solid like a rock. Not one who worries, panics, get overwhelmed by the slightest things, who makes problems bigger than they really are. She wants someone that's strong, like a rock, whom she can rely on, whom she feels safe around. Life's problems coming in, right? She wants someone who will see her safely through life, on whom she could actually always rely, not a weakling. And so to be that man, you need to be calm and in control. You should never be fazed by setbacks in life. You got to adapt an attitude that nothing's going to upset you, and you can handle whatever is thrown at you with grace, with competence. You're capable. You got to be an optimist, right? Optimism is attraction, right? Because it has a powerful underlying message. I'm confident. I'm capable. I'm optimistic. I'm an optimistic person. An optimistic person could actually take whatever life throws at them and remain undefeated and cheerful. Life does not make them bitter and unrespectful, right? This is inspiring and very attracted to women because it shows that the man is strong and dependable and fun. Everyone loves an optimist. So as long as it's not over the top. We're not talking about fist pumping. Life is 24/7, awesome, everything is excellent. Just a general, cheerful disposition and belief that things will work out in life in the end. That's what it is, King. That's what it is. That's the G code. You got to have style. Be clean. Be neat. Escalate. One of the main reasons why a man finds himself in the friend zone is because acting like a damn friend from the outset, from the inception of meeting her. And so acting like a friend is never going to get him any progress. You got to escalate the situation. Or he takes too long to progress. And you could actually take what I'm saying, or you stay in the friend zone. You can't rush, but you can delay. You cannot delay endlessly. You gotta advance. Understand? What are you waiting for? If a conversation is going well, ask for an email address. Ask for a phone number. You dig? You know what I mean? I prefer the email address over the phone number if you're in the dating game, right? If you've actually had an enjoyable afternoon with her afternoon getting together, go for the kiss. Stop being a damn simp. If you're kissing in the kitchen, take it to the bedroom. Remember, there's a window, King. There's a window for advancement. And if you don't take that window, you're going to be moved out of the way, and the next guy is going to be moved in, man. In every interaction, if you miss that window, it's gone forever. G-Code. In every interaction, if you miss that window, it's going forever. Stop trying to guess her thoughts, right? Stop trying to guess her thoughts and feelings, and just keep escalating your intentions with her. And don't tolerate poor treatment. And what I mean by that, you meet a woman, wherever you might meet her at, and you completely hit it off. She agrees to leave the bar with you or whatever, wherever you met her at. And you're on your way, and she bumps into one of her male friends, and she asks you, wait a minute. Will she catch up with him? Guess what? If you stand there like a damn simp as she chats away with this guy, you completely blown it. You just blew that. It's unlikely that the night will end up how you wanted it. You dig what I'm saying? Why? Because you've just broadcasted to everyone in the vicinity that you are a complete simp. You dig what I'm saying? There are now only two people on center stage. That's her and this guy that she just stopped and said she was going to catch up with. You are just a low extra standing in the wings, waiting for a part. See, what you should have done instead, right? Let me give you some game, man. Let me give you some G-code, right? I'm about to close this down. What you should have done instead, when she told you, hold on, I got to catch up with some friend, what a real alpha would do right there is walk off and start talking to other women. That's G-sh. You understand? That's how you handle that. You don't stand there like a damn simp. You should have actually done anything, right? Other than stand there like a simp waiting for his master. You dig? See, that's what she's doing you is an example of poor treatment. She don't treat no real man like that, man. That's poor treatment. Test that women often subject men to. And most of you don't get it. That's why I'm giving you the G-code, man. Women, especially women of high value, more attractive she is, more educated she is, a woman of high value, she will constantly test men like this. They will deliberately treat a man poorly to see how he gonna react to it. Stop me where I'm lying at. And if you roll over like a simp, you roll over and you take it, You just failed the test. If you make excuses for her actions and you take it, you just fell. You just fell into friend zone, you simp. If you throw a damn tantrum and you sort, you failed the test. See, women want and they need their chosen men to be strong. You need to be able to pass her test with flying colors. These tests are there to separate the weaker men who would take her crap from the stronger men who would stand up to her. G-Code, stop me where I'm lying at. She needs the latter. She doesn't want the weak men. So the lesson is, don't tolerate poor treatment. You understand? Don't be a simp. Don't be a simp, kid. Be a man. She will quickly get the message and respect and desire you if you act like a man. Don't overthink this stuff, right? In my conclusion, I'm going to tell you, man, don't overthink this, right? So at the end of the day, right, don't overthink this. You just have to go out there and start applying this stuff that I went over in this video right here, right? or the stream, whatever you want to call it, right? No one is expecting you to have it all figured out. Just continually improve yourself and be the best that you could be, right? Apply what you've learned here. G-Code, I gave you some real G stuff here. If you really pay attention to it and listen, there's no tutorer like experience, right? As with anything, it feels uncomfortable and awkward when you first learn how to do it. But with time, you're going to get good at it. Still not sure where you want to start at? Well, start talking to women more. That's all you got to do. You're uncomfortable talking to women, talk to them more. Talk to the supermarket cashier, right? Talk to the woman wherever, in the beauty salon, right? Talk to the woman at the bus stop. Talk to the woman in the line making a sandwich. You got to get comfortable talking to women. You've been a simp too long, man. Talk to the damn receptionist, right? Talk to your female colleague at work. Get in the habit of initiating conversations with women, regardless of whether you are actually attracted to them or not. Remember to ask questions. Ones that need more than a yes or no answer. Ask open-end questions. If you choose, or if you have a close female friend, spend more time asking her about attraction. What a woman looking for? Don't ask her answers at face value, but just consider her answers, because most women don't even know what they're looking for. You feel me? Do you understand? So, this is what it is, man. You can stop being a simp. You follow this, man. You will get out of that area of your life once and for all. Congratulations, right? The fact that you just listened to this right here means that you're serious about improving your success with women and stop being a simp. This means that the case you owe to yourself, check it off, man. You ready to take some progression now, right? So you got to get out there, man. Change your life. Stop being a simp. Stop being a wussy. You know what I mean? You know your woman is cheating on you or something like that. Get rid of her. Put her away. Don't fall for it anymore, man. Don't tolerate the foolishness anymore, man. You could go out and get whoever you want, man. Just be an alpha male. Stop making her feel like she's the prize and realize that you're the prize and start acting like you're the prize, man. That's how you give it up, man. That's the G-Code. So that's what it is, fellas. You like this, share it. Go back, listen to it. Some real game in here, man. And it really works if you apply it. But you really got to apply it, man. Don't just, I don't know. Your way hasn't been working. Time to try something different. It's the G-Code. So with that, I'm going to say shalom, man. Because the doc is out, man. Be safe, man. And remember to subscribe to A Spokesman for Men on YouTube and right here on Facebook, the Facebook group, A Spokesman for Men. Nobody's speaking up for men, so I guess I gotta do it. It's the G-Code. Shalom. Tell the doctor's out.